afternoon, Dunkirk and Fredonia listeners, and welcome back to News at Noon. News at Noon is brought to you by Fredonia Radio Systems on WCVF 88.9 and WDVL 89.5. I'm News Director Lee Pye here today with my news assistants Dan Quagliana, Sara Lodespoto, Joshua Ribakove, as well as Hunter Halterman and Sports Director Matt Volz. With this top of the hour update, we'll bring you the latest on SUNY Fredonia's campus news and events, sports, weather, music, as well as national and international news. First up, let's go to the event bulletin for this week. Radiothon, Radiothon, Radiothon! Fredonia Radio Systems is having their semesterly Radiothon this weekend. The event is 24 hours of live radio, where each hour is a different show created by the campus and community members. The event starts on Friday, December 1st at 12 p.m., kicking off with the legacy show High Noon Friday and ending the next day on December 2nd at noon, finishing off with the Big Cheeseburger Challenge. Make sure to tune in to our two stations this Friday and Saturday on WCVF 88.9 and WDVL 89.5. The club's Writers' Ring and English Honor Society Sigma Tau Delta are co-sponsoring an ice skating event. The English Department clubs are taking over the ice rink on campus on Friday, December 1st from 4 to 5 p.m. A hot chocolate bar will be there to warm the skaters up, and you'll be able to listen to the Fredonia English Department playlist. Tickets are being sold up until the event at the ticket office in the Williams Center. That's it for the information through the grapevines. Next up, we'll bring it to Dan for our latest campus news updates.
Thanks, Lee. On Friday, December 1st, the annual observance of World AIDS Day, Fredonia will be offering free AIDS testing in the Grosso Hall. Students can be tested for free with the Kembio HIV Half Stat Pack Assay Test, which is administered by a finger prick. Results will be known within 10 minutes and will be kept confidential. Students can register online or by scanning the QR code located on World AIDS Day posters around campus. World AIDS Day serves as a reminder to end HIV-related stigmas, an opportunity to honor those who have been lost, and to work towards a day when HIV is no longer a threat. Harmful algal blooms will be the topic of the next Brown Bag Talk, hosted by the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Visiting Assistant Professor Allison Hrisik will be exploring algal blooms in her presentation, titled Slow Then Sudden Changes, Understanding the Conditions That Lead to Harmful Algal Bloom. Dr. Hrisik will specifically discuss the slow buildup of events that lead to algal blooms, such as changes in water temperature, nutrients, water circulation, and weather patterns. Hrisik, who joined Fredonia's Department of Biology in January, works for the Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute, where she seeks to understand human impacts on lake ecosystems. The Brown Bag Talk will be held on Wednesday, December 6th at noon. Food and refreshments will be provided by FSA. Meraki, the Fall 2023 Senior Exhibition Show, opens on Friday, December 1st at the Kathy and Jesse Marion Art Gallery with a reception from 6 to 9 p.m. On display through December 10th, the exhibition includes ceramics, paintings, sculptures, photographs, and more, all designed by current seniors here at Fredonia. Both the exhibition and the preceding reception are free and open to the public. Meraki, the title chosen by the seniors who made the exhibition, is a Greek word that means labor of love or to do something with pleasure. In modern terminology, the word is used to describe doing something with soul, creativity, or love. To put something of yourself into what you're doing or designing, no matter what it is. That's it for campus news. Now let's send it back to Lee.
Thanks, Dan. Next up, we have local news. SUNY Fredonia is providing a scholarship for every high school in Chautauqua County. President Stephen Collison, Jr. announced at the October School Boards Association meeting that there is a new scholarship called the President's Award of Excellence Scholarship. The scholarship recognizes students for their outstanding academic performance with requirements of being a full-time student and that maintains a minimum of a 3.2 GPA and resides in a university residence hall or townhouse. Sylvester Cleary, the president of the Chautauqua County Board School Boards Association, said, quote, "We are proud to have to receive the President's Award of Excellence Scholarship. The scholarship will enable one student from every district in Chautauqua County to receive funds to pursue their college education at SUNY Fredonia. It will help out our students achieve their academic career and goals and make a positive impact on the world," end quote. A total of 20 scholarships for each school district in the county will will be made out to the students enrolling for SUNY Fredonia in their first year. Close to $500,000 will be available for over the next 4 years for these students. In September, Michael Pantano, a Silver Creek resident and bus driver, was driving his bus on Route 20 when an approaching vehicle crossed the lane and was heading towards the bus. Pantano swiftly maneuvered the bus to prevent a head-on collision, saving 11 students that were on the bus, and everyone walked away without injuries. Last week, Pantano received a commendation from legislator Tom Harriman on behalf of the Chautauqua County legislator, applauding him for his quick wits and heroic actions. To kick off the holiday season, the city of Dunkirk had an indoor and outdoor pop-up shopping event on Saturday. Multiple businesses and clubs participated, and the City Hall Christmas tree was lit up, and a horse-drawn carriage rides were offered throughout the day, along with a visit from Santa and Mrs. Claus. That's it for your local news update. Let's send it to the sports guy, Matt Volz.
Thanks, Lee, and good afternoon, everybody. The men's basketball team is back at it tonight as they travel to Pittsburgh to take on Chatham at 7 p.m. in a non-conference matchup. While students were away for the break, the team was down in Bradford taking on Pitt Bradford, falling 80-73. The Blue Devils can surpass last season's win total with a win tonight. The women's basketball team will look to continue their unbeaten streak as they head to Ohio to take on John Carroll tomorrow. The Blue Devils currently sit at 4-0 after taking down both William Smith and Cuca in Brockport on November 17th and 18th. They can match their win total from last season with a win tomorrow. The men's and women's swimming and diving teams hosted five other schools in a three-day invitational just before heading home for the break. The men's team finished in sixth place with a score of 323, while the women's team placed fifth with a score of 630.5. Both teams will head to Cortland for the Cortland Snow Flurries Invitational this weekend. And finally, the hockey team is on the road for a pair of SUNYAC matchups this weekend, taking on Geneseo at 7 p.m. on Friday and Brockport at 7 p.m. on Saturday. Fredonia will look to return to the win column following a 3-1 loss to defending national champion Hobart on November 18th. The Blue Devils will enter this weekend's contests at 2-6. Well, after an impressive comeback victory over the Pittsburgh Penguins on Friday night, a game that saw team captain Kyle Okposo score his first goal of the season, the Sabres were a complete no-show the next night, getting embarrassed by Lindy Ruff's New Jersey Devils 7-2. Buffalo mustered just 12 shots on goal, their lowest total since February of 2015. The Sabres are back at it tonight, taking on the league's best team, the New York Rangers, at Madison Square Garden. Puck drop is slated for 7 p.m. And in what may go down as the game of the year in the NFL, the Bills once again came up short, falling to the Philadelphia Eagles 37-34 in overtime. Despite a heroic effort from Josh Allen, who accounted for over 400 yards and four touchdowns, the Bills' defense was unable to stop a second-half Eagles barrage, surrendering 30 points in the second half and overtime. The Bills were also penalized 11 times for 80 yards, while Philadelphia was flagged four times for 30 yards. During the game, Bills defensive linemen Jordan Phillips and Shaq Lawson were caught on video having a heated interaction with Eagles fans, with Lawson possibly making forcible contact with one particular fan. The loss dropped the Bills' record to 6-6 as they enter their bye week. That's it for your sports update. Now let's take it to Sara for the weather.
Now here is your Northern Chautauqua weather update brought to you by Fredonia Radio Systems.
Hiya, I hope you all had a great Thanksgiving, and let's get right into the weather. Currently, we have a lake effect snow warning that started today at 10 a.m. and lasts till Wednesday at 7 a.m. I know, slight spoilers on our five-day forecast, but I'm sure you guys can handle it. This warning states that we're going to accumulate roughly 2 to 4 inches of snow each day with strong wind speeds. For example, today it's a chilly 39 that holds clouds filled with snow and intense wind squalls. Time to put my thick sweaters and jackets to work. I'm not trying to catch a cold this season. The temperatures drop into the upper 20s with a similar breezy snowfall as the daytime. Therefore, be careful driving tonight. Tomorrow promises the same results as today as it reaches 32 degrees. The dense snow clouds and harsh winds make me worry for you guys commuting. I 110% trust that you're going to be a safe driver. But Let me tell you, I do not trust this weather. So, just for me, be a little extra cautious. The snow continues throughout the night while it gets chilly entering to the mid-20s. That's it for your two-day weather. Keep listening, and I'll be back with the rest of your five-day forecast. For now, let's take it to Lee for a local music update.
I made out like a bandit. I made out with a lot of cash in my hand. I made out for the good Lord called me higher. I made out with a lovely.
If you go to this show, make sure to have your cowboy boots and cowboy boots for square dancing, because Last Call Entertainment is presenting folk music in Fredonia. High Noon Friday, the variety show of 40 years from Fredonia Radio Systems, is hosting the event. Bands and artists that are playing are Milkweed and the Hartwell Hospice House Band, While Something in Affliction, Two Peas in a Pod, and Jacob Cantner, which is what you're hearing right now. The music is at BJ's at 51 West Main Street, Fredonia. Doors are at 9 p.m. and music is at 10 p.m. In other music news, Last Call Entertainment is hosting their last show of the fall semester at BJ's. Bands like Relentless Moisture, Mimic, Hit Girl, and Cornflake Car will be playing on December 7th at 51 West Main Street in Fredonia. Again, doors are at 9 p.m. and music is at 10 p.m. That's it for music news this week. Let's bring it to Josh for national and international news.
The officer who murdered George Floyd, Derek Chauvin, was stabbed in prison on Friday. The Bureau of Prisons confirmed that an unnamed inmate from the Federal Correction Institution located at Tucson, Arizona, was taken to a hospital to perform life-saving measures on Friday around 12:30. Chauvin's lawyer, Eric Nelson, had previously raised concern that the former Minnesota cop would likely be a target for violence in prison, and Nelson has claimed that he should be kept away from the rest of the general population. The Minnesota Attorney General, Keith Ellison, told the Star Tribune, quote, "I am sad to hear that Derek Chauvin was the target of violence. He was duly convicted of his crimes, and like any incarcerated individual, he should be able to serve his sentence without fear of retaliation or violence," end quote. The 47-year-old former police officer remains in stable condition, and the man who stabbed him has not yet been publicly named. Much has happened between Hamas and Israel throughout the past week, but arguably one of the most significant updates has been the freeing of hostages. Yesterday, Hamas returned its third batch of hostages to Israel, including 14 Israelis and the first American hostage to be freed. In return, Israel freed 39 Palestinian prisoners. Today is the last day of the current ceasefire, and a fourth batch of hostages is expected to follow, including a total of 50 hostages being released and 150 prisoners being released. However, the ceasefire could potentially be extended, with an alleged deal between Netanyahu and Biden offering to extend the ceasefire by an extra day for every 10 hostages released. Netanyahu also claimed that once the ceasefire is over, Israel will resume their offensive, quote, "with all our might," end quote. Do you drive a Honda? Well, now may be the time to get it checked out. If you drive a 2023 Honda Accord or 2023 Honda HR-V, your seatbelt might not hold you back in the case of a collision. Honda has just released a recall on 300,000 of their 2023 model Accord and HR-V vehicles, stating that, quote, "front seat belt pretensioners were assembled without a rivet securing the quick connector and wire plate," end quote. Although over a quarter of a million of the vehicles are on recall, Honda estimates that only about 1% of them actually have the problem. Starting January 8th, Honda will begin contacting affected owners by mail, requesting drivers to take the vehicles to the nearest Honda dealer for an inspection. If necessary, the part will be replaced, and owners who pay to have the repair done at their own expense may be eligible for reimbursement. That's all for today's national and international news. Now let's take it back to Sara for the rest of this week's weather forecast.
Hi again. I'm not going to lie. The two-day forecast was a little nerve-wracking with the whole lake effect snow warning. I was definitely shaking in my boots for a minute. However, I like to look at the positive, and in this case, we can look forward to a better forecast ahead. It's not much, but I always love a bit of progress. Wednesday has the last of the lake effect in the morning, leaving us with dense cloud covering and about a foot of total storm snowfall and a high of 36. I just got these new boots last month, so I'm excited to test them out. Can they withstand Western New York snow? Only time will tell. Later into the evening, we get a slight comeback of snow, but quickly dissipates to just low clouds while it dips into the mid-30s. Finally, we get some sunshine as we discuss Thursday. Nothing too crazy, but the clouds clear up a bit as it reaches 46 degrees. The harsh winds will probably make us feel colder, so grab a nice hot tea. If you don't like tea, consider drinking some hot chocolate. Just don't forget the marshmallows. As we descend into the upper 30s, the clouds start to drizzle and progress into harder rain. Before you know it, we begin December on Friday with thick clouds covering our sky in the mid-40s. Time really does fly fast. November is over just like that. As the afternoon enters into the night, it begins to drizzle sporadically, dropping into the mid-30s. That's it for your five-day forecast. Let's take it right back to Lee.
That'll wrap up for today's edition of News at Noon. Campus News is written and read by Dan Quagliana. Local news for this broadcast is prepared by Lee Pye. Weather is presented by Sara Lodespoto. Sports is presented by Matt Volz. Music is prepared by Lee Pye. National and international news is prepared by Joshua Ribakove. And finally, board operations for this broadcast are performed by Hunter Halterman, whose birthday is today. Thank you for tuning in to News at Noon. Join us every Monday and Wednesday at 12 p.m. on WCVF 88.9 and WDVL 89.5. From all of us at Fredonia Radio Systems, have a wonderful day.